What's up, guys? Welcome back to Fish of Hex. My name is Travis. Today we're here in the fish room looking at the 120 gallon reef tank, which is our very first build for our Reef Tanks for Veterans program. And I just want to give a quick shout out to customaquariums.com for sponsoring the tank, the stand, and their seamless sump filtration. Definitely appreciate it. Now, when it comes to Custom Aquariums and myself, basically when you buy an aquarium or a setup through me, I get a certain percentage of that sale. Now, what I've decided to do is instead of taking that money, I would just go ahead and let Custom Aquariums keep it, and then we'll put that towards these builds. So if you're interested in a setup like my 300 or like this 120, please contact me through my email, fishofhex@gmail.com. And again, if you go through me, not only do you get a discount on your purchase, but you also get to contribute to these builds. So just a quick reminder on that. Now, when it comes to this setup, we have the 120 gallon 4 foot by 2 foot by 2 foot with the ultra clear glass all the way around and their H2 overflow. Now this is going to be the same type of overflow, the same type of glass, and the same type of stand that I have on my 300 gallon. And that's really what I wanted. I wanted to give a smaller version of my 300 because people really like that tank. And I figured this would be a good first build and an opportunity to kind of spread the love when it comes to that setup. Now, when it comes to filtration, we have the bigger section here, which comes back down from the H2 overflow box into this first chamber, which has filter socks and what we will consider the refugium. Now, I will add my own DIY refugium lights to this that you guys see on my other refugiums. They grow macroalgae like crazy, so I figured that'd be pretty cool to add them to this setup, and they'll shine directly down through this glass. And what's pretty cool is you can come in here and just stick your finger and lift this glass up if you ever need to remove it, so if you need to clean it or anything like that. The next chamber, we have a media chamber where we can put some kind of like bio bowls or balls or anything like that. Here's some of the baskets. And then over to the right, we have the skimmer section and the return section. So we have a Bubble Magus Curve 7 that just came in today from Marine Depot. And then we have the CCHA return pump that was donated from a local hobbyist. Pretty good pump. It's going to work out great for this tank size, and it's a reliable pump, so that's what's really important. Now, when it comes to equipment for the inside, I have already picked up some WP-40s. We're going to do two of them. They're kind of in transit through eBay, so they'll be here. So that will be our flow. We have a standard Apex with the temperature and pH probe, and I decided to go with the standard because, to be honest, I find that ORP and the salinity probe are just pointless. Unless you know specifically what ORP is and how it fluctuates, it's kind of pointless to look at. And the salinity probe is notorious for just not staying calibrated. So it's just, I figured we'll save a couple hundred bucks, go with the standard Apex, which is still a great controller without having that extra monitoring, which we don't even use anyways. Now, when it comes to lighting, I have not picked it up because I don't know who's going to get this tank yet. Now, the reason why I want to wait is because I want to know what kind of experience the person has, how long they've been in the hobby, what kind of coral they're growing, what kind of tank they want this to be. If it's just a fish only, we're going to go with a different type of lighting if we were going with a full Acropora tank. And so I'm going to wait until we get pick the winner within the next 30 days and then sit down and talk to them and figure out what they want to do with this system. And then I'll go ahead and purchase the lighting. Now, we do have some glass tops, which will sit on top of here. Make sure your fish don't jump out or anything like that. Good to go. And then you guys have noticed that there is some other tops. Ooh, camera jacking it up. There's some sections here that are blocked off with acrylic. And then there's a section here for glass if we needed it, if we didn't want to have the skimmer or anything like that. And then, of course, we have the glass top here. So it's going to be pretty much enclosed. The evaporation will be minimum. There's plenty of room for an ATO and all sorts of stuff down there. Now, of course, the ATO reservoir will probably have to be somewhere else since we are pretty limited on space. But we could always fit a small acrylic container there and then go about it that way. So we are also going to be doing, I haven't really picked out what ATO yet. It's going to depend on, again, what kind of container. If we get a smaller container that we do want to fit on the side here, of course the pump will have to be smaller to be able to fit in there. So that stuff we're going to figure out as we go. It's going to be the last minute tweaks, which of course, if you've ever built a reef tank, there's always last minute adjustments. And instead of purchasing that stuff and finding out we might not need it, I'm just going to go ahead and wait until we figure out who's getting it, where it's going, what they're going to be growing in it, or what kind of tank it is, and then finalize those little things. So now, the process for winning this is pretty simple. All you have to be is a veteran of any war. It doesn't matter if it was Afghanistan, Iraq, if it was Korea, if it was Vietnam. It doesn't matter. It could be any war from the beginning of time to now, if you're still alive and you got PTSD, then you are gonna be qualified to win this build. Now, down the road, we might change it up and require you to have combat action, because that's pretty important to me. I find that people who go through combat and experience firefights and experience IEDs and deal with that struggle of life and death, they have the more severe PTSD than just some dude who got mortared while he was taking a shit in the port-a-john and still got to claim PTSD. I mean, there's different things that people do, and we're gonna probably narrow it down to just combat action in a future build, but for now, this one's just gonna be, you have to have at least 20% post-traumatic stress on your original disability rating through the VA. Now, you'll have to prove that via, you know, your disability forms once we go through the whole process and I kind of narrow you down out of however many applications we get through the process. And again, it's nothing personal when it comes to future builds and not having combat action versus having it. It's just one of those things that it's just a personal preference. I have combat action. The people that I know that have dealt with PTSD also have combat action. And then I also know people who have not that still claim PTSD, and you know that they're okay. So it's just one of those things that is personal to me, and I want to make sure that people who get these builds that we put a lot of money into, donations, coral sales, all that kind of stuff, they go to the right person. And for this one, I just want to make sure that it goes to somebody who needs it, who really finds that it's going to benefit them and their lives and help them with their PTSD, and it's really going to just improve their overall lifestyle. And that's not going to matter if you have combat action or not. It's more or less coming down to what this build can do for you. And of course, we'll make adjustments down the road as we have more of these builds. And there will be more of them more often. This is just a really expensive build for our first one. Maybe our next one will be something like a 120 that's more of a DIY setup. Or maybe we'll do an all-in-one that we just kind of plug and play. It's just going to depend on what we want to do and kind of what route we go. Now, if you are interested in applying to win this tank, all you have to do is email me at fishofhex@gmail.com. Just give me a little bit of background on you, kind of what you're dealing with, where you live. We are going to keep this within Pennsylvania and the surrounding states, so Ohio, Maryland, New York, Massachusetts. I will even go up to Vermont because I have some family up there, so I don't mind making that trip. It'd be like a two birds kind of thing. And then we have, any state surrounding, New Jersey, stuff like that. We can make that trip. Now, I have set some money aside, and I do have some volunteers, so we can pay for a trailer, pay for gas, again, pay for all those odds and ends that we might miss, PVC, glue, all sorts of stuff. You guys know how it is when it comes to building. So I have set a pretty decent chunk of money aside to cover all those expenses to make sure everybody has food, and it's just really going to be a good day. So if you are interested in winning, please contact me, and we'll go through the whole process, and I will announce the winner of this within the next 30 days, and then you guys should expect to see this tank up within the next month. Within a month after I announce the winner. That's going to be the plan. And so that's about it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you have any questions, let me know. If you want to support this and support the channel, you can, again, contact me for custom aquariums, tanks, or you can go through my website, purchase coral, and we can use the 10% of those sales to go ahead and go towards this program. So with that said, I'll see you guys in a couple days with another video. All right, peace.